wait. Mongbo, wait. Duro. Wait. Oh, I've done something, oh, hey!
Welcome back to my YouTube channel, guys. Today, I'll be making some Nigerian beans. Not your regular schmegler beans, but the beans with flavor. You know, a little pizzazz behind it. If you're interested, make sure you like and subscribe. I got new stuff that I'll be making that I want you to try. Yeah, let's get right into it.
Shot, one opportunity to seize everything you ever wanted, one moment that you captured.
Alrighty, to get started, we got some black-eyed peas. Now, the quantity I make, it's a lot. My parents love beans, I love beans, so I use the whole bag. Now, this is going to fill up your fridge, okay? You're gonna be good for maybe a week and a half. I swear for God. If you eat this by yourself, maybe even 2 weeks. But you wanna fill the water up that much, put your beans on high heat, and you're gonna cook it for about like 15 minutes. Just 15 minutes for the time being. This is a long process. Although it is easy, it does take time. So if you're looking something fast and easy, this is not it, okay? But it's worth it, I promise. After it's done cooking for about 15 minutes, you want to go ahead and strain it from all the water that was previously in there. See that pot? That means that we'd be cooking all day. So you want to drain it all out from that black water as you see there. You want to drain that out, and we're going to refill that pot up again to cook that beans even longer. Now really look at how much water I put in there, because that's mostly important. You don't want your beans to burn at the bottom. Now after we basically have that going, we're gonna add some chopped onion. That's a whole onion, and the most important ingredient.
It's time for the moment you've been waiting for.
Know anything about plantain is delicious, and we're gonna go ahead and throw that in a pot while it all cooks together. Now adding these plantains will bring so much sweetness, like light sweetness to it, and like the savoriness from the beans already kills it itself. And then you want to also add like this palm oil called Zumi palm oil, super good. As you can see, this is how much I put in there. I'll also go in later and add a little bit more, but it's all up to you. You probably know nothing about this, so it's all up to me. So follow instructional notes. Just kidding. I'm gonna go ahead and stir it up. And you're gonna do this periodically. This is it almost cooked, halfway cooked. It's gonna take about 50 minutes, okay? This is gonna be a process, but like I said, it is worth the wait. I go ahead and add some dry pepper. You can use regular pepper, paprika, whatever you're into. At this time, I'm probably gonna go ahead and season everything. Add some salt in there, just to give it a little bit more of a kick, because you know, all that water dilutes everything, so you wanna keep it all, you know, flavorful. Go ahead and stir it around. Gonna add a little more palm oil like I told you I would, and just to make sure like the color is there. Like if you don't see the color while it's cooking, then you're not cooking it right. But don't overwhelm yourself with oil. I just like it, the color, a lot. It makes the flavor really make a difference, to be honest. You want to put the lid over the pot, and then also I like to add like Goya seasoning. It's total seasoning is vegan. It's really nice, a lot of flavor packed in there. And you never want to over season, but you want to make sure you have just enough. And periodically, you want to just try your food. Just try it. And if your reaction, is like this, your food is nasty. Period. Should it be? Should it be? And in about 50 minutes, it should look like this. Mwah. You're welcome.
All right, guys. Now that is up for the beans recipe. I wanted to push the envelope a little bit further. See what I can do with just beans, because I usually do with jello fries. But you know what? We're trying to do something different. 2019, the game has changed. So I want to make tacos. And this is going to be like a Nigerian-Mexican infused type thing. So y'all get ready. This is about to get crazy. So when I went to the Vegan Fest the other day, I picked up this bad boy. It's called Beyond Better Cashew Sauce. It's like a zesty black bean, and it's like a type of alternative for cheese. I had a taste of it, a sample of it, and it was phenomenal. So I think that this will pair well. Then I'm gonna like chop up some chicken that I have, and then I'll make some tacos out of it. So let's see how this works. So the ingredient says that this directions are for 2 servings. I'm okay with that, because you know they be saying 2 servings and really be 1. I don't got time. So we're gonna go with this serving. So it's gonna be 1/2 cup of the bag. Wow, a whole cup. We're gonna do 1.5 cup of the bag to 1 cup of water in a saucepan and stir. We're gonna do that. We got pan, rinsed, get it, play, 1/2. I don't get copyrighted for this. I'm turning this off. This right here, y'all, this smell like heaven. Yeah, y'all, let's take a spray. Okay. Oh man, okay. So, like I said, ingredients. I got a new pan because I was feeling like maybe I was doing it wrong already. I overthink things, and that's why my food always tastes good. Measure. And you can buy this on Amazon. They say they sell their products on there. Because that's what I was wondering. I was like, how come I've never seen anything like this before? So just 1/2 cup of that. We're just gonna add it to our pot. Let me try to get that in there. Yeah, we're gonna go ahead and add that. Like it said, right? Huh? Boom. And then 1/2 cup of the bag and 1 cup of water. Oh, you can microwave this thing too. Ooh. Now we're gonna do it the right way. Let's take a cup of water. Simple. They didn't make it too hard to like do, which is pretty dope. Life is easier when you make it easier, right? Exactly. So it says, you boil it on medium to high heat while stirring, and boil and stir for 30 seconds until it's thick. All right, cool. Let's get that popping. Yeah, high, medium, cool. Let's make some shape. So like the instruction says, we're gonna let it set and we'll let it cook on a high, medium heat while stirring. So it's gonna boil soon. Okay, I see the bubbles. Here. Use a fufu stick, because we're gonna make this like, what? Oh, hold on. Wait. Ooh, that got thicker than I thought real fast. They asked me for no oil. Hold up. This dog is actually weird. I ain't gonna lie, I got this dog like 1/2 year ago. And he's interesting. You know, I'm not used to having a larger dog. I feel like they got too much brain of their own. It's quite interesting. So I'm thinking that, so only 30 seconds? Oh my gosh. Y'all. No way. We're gonna keep letting this cook. Ain't no way, 30 seconds. This is getting cooked real fast though, y'all. I'm not sure if it's ready, let's try it. Can you imagine they said this is two servings? Who thought I would be eating this, eh? I ain't gonna lie, this look ready already. It's definitely more, the consistency is definitely more cheesy, I would say. Not necessarily, but I remember. Okay, we need to cook a little bit longer. Do a little cooking. Okay. They gas that. It definitely needs to be a little bit lower in the heat, guys. Don't burn your cheese. I think it's cool at this point. Y'all, look at this. Let me get y'all some closer footage. Look at that. I'm not gonna burn this thing. It looks like it's about done. Oh man. That's the taste I remember. Right there. That's it. Wow. Whoa. Try it again, cause y'all know. Consistency, y'all see that? I'm gonna let that heat up again. Wish I had an angle where I could record the food and me. Maybe. Nah, this is cool enough. Y'all get the gist, y'all see me. I'm gonna put it on medium. I'm gonna use grapeseed oil. And anybody know who use grapeseed oil? That thing got more flavor than anything else. That much in there. Take my Guardian crispy chicken. Now it comes with the package in there. I'm not gonna be using that. We're just gonna use the chicken, okay? We're gonna, that's how it's gonna look. We're gonna put that thing in there. Well, you know what? We're gonna let the stove heat up a little bit. I'm kind of waiting for this. I'm waiting for an hour for those beans to cook. Not acceptable. Oil already heats up pretty fast. Let's go ahead and place that in there, like so. And on the box, I believe it said 8 minutes. So I believe that means 4 minutes on both sides. So y'all, add a little bell pepper. I got kind of inspired, but like I was thinking Mexican. So let's think what they usually have is bell peppers in there. And a little onion. Anything with a cookie stick. Look at that. I'm gonna use this. I don't know if y'all can get it from everywhere, but use your Mexican seasoning, y'all. Ooh. Off my thing. Oh. Oh my God, y'all. How we coming? How we coming, y'all. This is how we're what? Come in. Chicken nuggets. Alright, it's burning at this point. So we are really cooking it up, y'all. We really lit. Fiesta, fiesta. Hold on, hold on. Opa, you dig? Hold on. Let me get this hoe. Y'all seeing this? You're oh, wow. All right, guys, so this is the finishing look. It looks disgusting, but I'm sure it's absolutely delicious. Because guess what? I made it. Cheers. Oh my God. Oh my God. Mama. Oh my God. Wait. Mongbo, wait. Duro. Wait. Oh, I've done something. Oh, hey. Hold on, wait. Home. Oh my God. No cap. I done did some. I really done. Go. Hold on. You know what? That concludes the video. Thank you so much for watching. I'm hungry. Bye, guys.